How was work?
Work was same as every other day.
You know, when Paul and I started writing this story, my office is in the Lower East Side, and we were just kind of writing what was around us. We started with this character of Max Simpkin that we had our eye set early on Adam and didn't know if we'd ever actually get him, but we thought, let's write it, and then we'll approach him, and when he says no, we'll get Paul Giamatti. And and luckily, Adam said yes. And We didn't have to go to Giamatti.
Oh, Giamatti was so wanting it.
He's so angry about that. But he brought up the storyboards. I think the movie has its own unique sort of flavor that way. It kind of keeps you guessing of where it's going, and they were a lot of fun elements to play with.
What drew you to the project?
McCarthy, the story, the connection to the neighborhood and stuff, and my family, and just it felt like a relationship I've seen with either friends of my family or cousins, or just very New York and very, you know, it can be a secluded life when you're just taking care of mama and you have nothing else, no social life, no anything, and just work and mom and work and mom. And it was just nice to see this guy try to get something else.
You guys almost threw in like a Marvel-esque ending there at the
That's
end.
That's right. That was neat.
You know Marvel's going to be mad at us. I think we got to the end of the story and we're like, we kind of wrote a superhero story in reverse.
The scarf was the cape of it all.
The magic machine, and we had all these like little motifs that were just really fun to play with, and we had a lot of great actors, really great actors, who were willing to jump in and play along, and you know, you're lucky when you get to tell a story like that.